Catholic Church leader Pope Francis arrived at the Soekarno-Hatta Airport at 11:30 a.m. on September 3. The pontiff's arrival was welcomed by two children wearing Papuan and Javanese traditional clothes. They presented him with a hand bouquet that was specially made for his arrival. The bouquet symbolizes Indonesia's motto, Bhinneka Tunggal Ika, which means unity in diversity. Bhinneka Tunggal Ika was also mentioned on September 4 by President Joko Widodo as he discussed his efforts, including the situation in Palestine. The President also introduced Defense Minister Prabowo Subianto to the Pope as the President-elect. In his speech to the Indonesian authorities, the pontiff warned that such diversity can also become a source of conflict.
L'armonia nel rispetto delle diversità si raggiunge quando ogni visione particolare tiene conto delle necessità comuni e quando ogni gruppo etnico e confessione religiosa agiscono in spirito di fraternità, perseguendo il nobile fine di servire il bene di tutti.
Pope Francis also visited the Grand Mosque of Istiqlal for interreligious meeting on September 5. During the meeting, he delivered the message about unity in diversity and the importance of friendship between religions. Pope Francis met and blessed several attendees before visiting the Friendship Tunnel, which connects Istiqlal Mosque and Jakarta Cathedral. This tunnel symbolizes religious tolerance in the country. Meanwhile, Istiqlal Mosque Grand Imam Nasaruddin Umar expressed his hope for a peaceful living and global diversity in his speech.
Kita juga saat ini sedang menghadapi krisis lingkungan, perubahan iklim, pemanasan global, dan masalah lingkungan lainnya yang mengancam kehidupan kita. Oleh karena itu, pertemuan dan dialog para tokoh agama seperti yang dilaksanakan hari ini sangatlah penting dan dibutuhkan dalam menyelesaikan persoalan-persoalan kemanusiaan dan ancaman-ancaman kerusakan lingkungan.
On the same day, Pope Francis then led a grand mass at the Gelora Bung Karno Stadium, which was attended by 86,000 Catholic devotees. It also marked the end of his official visit to Indonesia. Afterwards on Friday, President Widodo highlights another discussion with the Pope about the importance of inheriting children as the future of humanity.
Waktu saya bercerita, menyampaikan bahwa di Indonesia untuk masalah orang tua atau anak-anak muda kita yang mempunyai anak 3-4, beliau kaget sekali karena beliau bercerita saat di tetatet bahwa di banyak negara sekarang ini orang sudah tidak senang memiliki anak dan beliau sangat menghargai.
Indonesia is the first leg of the Pope's 12-day apostolic visit to four countries across Southeast Asia and Oceania. He continues his trip to Papua New Guinea on Friday. Sidoarjo News Team reporting from Jakarta.